Hello students, this is your course on content marketing. In this video on measuring content marketing performance, we are going to talk about using KPIs as reference points for measurement. Now, if you remember, we discussed about KPIs or key performance indicators in the very first chapter itself when we were talking about content marketing goals. So it sort of comes full circle when you are beginning your content marketing strategy design by setting some goals and aligning those goals with clear key performance indicators. And finally, once you have designed your content, promoted it, and now it's time to see how it is performing, you go back to those KPIs to see how every aspect of your content and different content formats, different content channels that you have used are actually doing. So KPIs are a way of measuring how each and every goal that was set in the beginning before any content campaign was designed or executed has been achieved. Now these KPIs can be directly divided into four main stages of customer activity or content performance. The first early stage is when your goal is to generate traffic and brand awareness, and therefore a very clear KPI becomes the numbers, traffic. How many people are coming on your platform? So the tactics that are used for achieving this goal is blog posts, curated lists, email marketing, thought leadership, social media events. And for each of them, since your goal is just to generate traffic, so what you measure is the number of visitors, the number of clicks, the number of open in case of email marketing, the number of likes and shares in case of social media events, and definitely the overall traffic on your website that is generated through all these activities, as well as the content that you're hosting on your website. So that is an early stage goal which gets measured through these KPIs, that is traffic, open rate, or clicks or shares. Then as your marketing strategy matures, and now you don't just want customers to know about you or come and visit your website, you want them to buy from you. So your goal turns from generating traffic to generating leads. The tactics you use here are case studies, analysis reports, webinars, best practice guides, newsletters, events. And for each of these, what you are trying to capture is customer information. You are not trying to give this kind of content away for free. Although it is free, but what you're technically earning out of it is customer information and an indication how many customers who are visiting your website are actually interested in the kind of products and services you produce and buying from you perhaps. So in this case, what you try to measure is the number of subscriptions, number of registrations, number of leads generated through these various type of content serving as lead magnets. Then again, as you move forward and you now want these leads to be converted, the goal becomes lead conversion, and you try to adopt tactics like newsletters, demos, trials, comparison guides, price sheets, smaller invite-only events. And now what you want to measure is that through these activities, through this kind of content which you are generating and sharing with these type of customers who are the ones that shared their email information or contact information with you, and therefore this is a specific type of targeted content for them. Now what you try to measure is actual conversions, and therefore that becomes a KPI, and what you try to measure is actual revenue also at times, which is generated with the help of such content. Ultimately, once you have these things going, you have an organic traffic happening consistently on your website, leads getting generated, conversions happening. Now, what you have to focus on is retaining the customers who are doing business with you, because it's definitely easier to retain than to acquire new customers, especially in the content marketing space. So this also gives you the opportunity to upsell your existing portfolio products to your new customer to your current customers and turn them into brand advocates so that they can generate positive testimonials about your offerings on various social media platforms for your website also. So what you try to do here is once again offer them case studies, consulting services, client workshops can be organized, product updates can be offered to them, and tutorials or training can be offered to them, advocacy programs can be arranged for them. And not all of this content has to be free. It could be at a subsidized rate for your loyal customers, which you remember we discussed when we were talking about using content as a reward for customer loyalty. And what you try to measure here is that how many such activities result in increased business from retained customers, how many such content distribution results in user-generated testimonials and social media content for your brand. So with each stage of your content marketing activities, you have clear goals, you have clear tactics, and therefore you have clear associated KPIs to measure. Now, for measuring different content types, usually there are n number of KPIs which you can choose from, you can adopt from, and you have to set these in the very beginning for your team, because unless you identify what KPIs will be measured at the end of the day to understand how a particular content performed and how therefore the team responsible for creating that content performed, you would have a directionless or a clueless kind of an atmosphere in your content team. And therefore, this is not something which you can do in the end. This is something which has to be clearly defined in the beginning itself. For instance, for content type like blog posts, articles, basically written content with limited research and effort, you can measure website traffic, unique visitors, new versus returning visitors, time spent on site, average time on page, bounce rate, exit rate, page views per site, traffic sources, geographic trends, mobile visitors, desktop visitors, visits per channel. And depending upon how you want to shape your content campaign, you can choose some of these KPIs. Similarly, for email, you can, if you're very new in the space, if you've just started acquiring customers, maybe you can focus on open rate. Eventually, you can move on to click-through rate, then churn rate, subscribers, opt-out rate, conversion rate. Delivery rate is something when you are engaging a third-party partner and are unsure of the quality of data which you have. So in the beginning, even before you start checking open rate, you can check delivery rate also to improve your customer data to work with. Yeah, when you have content design for social media campaigns, then you can also check the amplification rate, that how much of a reach your post was able to achieve, and how many times it was liked, it was shared, applause rate, followers or fans acquired through a specific campaign or in a given period of time. Landing page conversion rate can also be checked, especially if you're trying to drive traffic from social media to your website. And then return on engagement, what is that exactly? You may have followers and you may have subscribers and so many likes happening on every post that you're publishing on social media platforms, but is that leading to any kind of business also, or is that creating any favorable brand opportunity for you? That can also be measured. Then videos, if you are publishing those, especially on your channel, YouTube channel, or on your website, then you can measure for this particular content the number of views, the number of unique viewers, average view duration, just to tell you whether a customer is consuming the entire content or leaving midway, then number of subscribers for the channel, impression click-through rate, that if somebody is seeing suggestion for your video, how likely are they to click on that particular suggestion and therefore consume the content that you have created. YouTube CTAs can also be measured, especially if within your videos you are inserting clear call to actions like subscribe here or for more information, go to this website and buy. You can also measure shares, comments, and traffic sources for your video content to better understand which channels are promoting it better and how much of a popularity this content is enjoying. Then for podcasts, you can once again measure number of subscribers, number of backlinks that are leading to that podcast, giving you an indication how well your content is getting promoted, number of downloads that are happening. So that tells you what percentage of your subscribed customers are actually actively accessing this content, number of social shares, and this would tell you that what the intended value for the podcast was, it was achieved by your target customers and they were so delighted that and so engaged with the content that they bothered to share it again on social media platforms. You can also track reviews and ratings, giving you a lot of insight into what could be your next move for developing the same kind of content. Then for PPC campaigns, which form usually a bulk of the content which many content marketers land up producing. PPC, by the way, is pay-per-click campaigns. You can measure cost per click, click-through rate, ad position, conversions, conversion rate, cost per conversion, cost per sale, return on ad spend, that is ROI, wasted spend, impressions, quality score, and total spend. And a lot of these KPIs are readily available on the platforms like Google Analytics and Google Ads. All you need to do is tag your relevant content in the right manner and therefore ensure as soon as you are going live with your content that the right activity is getting measured, it's getting tracked, and therefore you're getting the informative dashboards generated in a real-time basis. Now, industry-wide, these are some of the KPIs which are actually very popular, and many of the digital marketing managers, content marketing managers, and marketing managers in general adopt these as the leading KPIs for starting to measure content performance. Eventually, depending upon the content formats that they prefer, channels that they prefer, they can choose and select many more, much deeper KPIs or sub-KPIs to measure the performance of their content. But these are usually the ones that pretty much every content marketing manager should be aware of and should be tracking. So it's definitely the organic traffic that is coming to your website without spending any money on promotion or influencers or affiliation. How good is your content at pulling organic traffic? That is what this KPI checks. Then number of leads generated through your content, sessions or page views is another check of quality of content. Conversion rate, just like leads, again, a very business focused KPI. Time spent on page, like sessions or page views, is again quality of content check. Social shares check, quality of content as well as customer engagement and relevance. Bounce rate checks relevance and quality of content. ROI, business focused, you check that whatever investment you made in creation of content, what is the return you're getting on it? And this return need not necessarily be in terms of actual revenue or profit. It could be in terms of customer acquisition. It could be in terms of lead capture also. Then backlinks, comments, and any other KPI which could give you more insight into how your overall content strategy is performing are also checked and tracked by content marketers, but to a limited level. But as you can see, the top KPIs are simple to track and are very strong indicators that your content is on point. And therefore, you have to remember to start measuring them from the get-go. The final measure of performance, as I was mentioning earlier, is your return on investment. And therefore, every KPI, even the ones which I mentioned that are focused on looking at the quality of content and the engagement of customers, are also ultimately moving towards giving you the ROI. Good quality content would definitely mean reduced ad cost, cost per click, and would definitely means better leads, better conversions. So it's all interconnected. And for content marketing, therefore, while investment can mean cost of producing content, cost of sourcing content externally, especially when you are curating from paid sources or you are using paid tools to curate and you are using freelancers to get or agency partners to get content, then investment can also means time spent planning and managing a content strategy, and therefore the cost borne by the company in managing this team or paying this team who is responsible for content strategy. Then investment can also mean from content marketing perspective in terms of content distribution and advertising, money you're spending on promoting your content on various social media platforms, search engine platforms, and ultimately various softwares and tools which you're using for managing your content, for tracking your content, for promoting your content, or for even for designing and development. So these kind of investments are the ones that actually go into content marketing, and the returns which are expected in from these investments are, of course, in terms of brand awareness, thought leadership, increasing leads and revenue, obvious returns which are there for as a concern for every business. Then search engine optimization, so what is the rank that your pages are achieving naturally, organically, the amount of traffic, how it has increased on your website, on your social platforms, that is also considered as a return on investment. And definitely conversions in terms of subscribers, in terms of purchases, however small the revenue, if more and more customers are getting converted, that is also seen as a good return on quality content, which is created as a result of conscious investment in content marketing efforts. So you have to remember that a lot of the KPIs that we try to measure, the end goal is to understand whether it would result in generating these returns on whatever investment has been made in content marketing activities. And therefore, in the subsequent videos, we are going to talk about various important KPIs which can help you measure your content's performance in various aspects. The next up, we'll talk about click-through ratio and how that is a significant KPI or a metric for measuring content performance. Until then, thank you.